Philippine shares joined most Asian stocks push higher on Wednesday, following a patchy rally on Wall Street overnight. The PSE index climbed for a fifth session in a row, this time closing just a touch below 7,100, a day before the Banco Central holds its first policy meeting for the year.
At a certain point, though, it's really not the BSP anyway, but it's more the other incentives that have to come in. Is there really a demand for additional loans, no, aside from working capital? Because I guess demand, there's already adequate supply capacity, so there really is very little capex left. It's really more for their inventories. Mm-hmm. And some are not even importing yet because of they don't see the demand. So we really have to get the people to be comfortable and consumption to start.
Francisco expects the local bourse to stay choppy amid uncertainties over the vaccine rollout, but he says it should stabilize towards the end of the year with a 10% gain in the index. And while foreign funds net bought the local bourse again, there are still net outflows year to date.
Outside of the few banks, I think that the fact that the retail spending has yet to come through, and that obviously is a bigger component of the Philippines index, and that's because of COVID-19, that has yet to take off.
So far, the Philippine market, together with Malaysia, are among the laggards in the region. In the earnings stream, Globe Telecom posts a 38% decline in its fourth quarter net income to just 2.7 billion pesos quarter on quarter, bringing full-year profit to 18.6 billion. This as weaker mobile services offset strength in broadband data. For 2021, it's looking at low to mid-single-digit growth in revenues, with 70 billion pesos in capex. It also expects to see an upswing in depreciation charges and lower share in equity losses from its fintech arm, Mint. In other news, air conditioning and refrigerator company Concepcion Industrial posts a 29% drop in 2020 net sales to 10.8 billion pesos, while full-year profit after tax and minority interests was halved to 471 million pesos as last year's lockdown slowed down demand from both consumer and commercial markets. It notes, recovery started by the second half of last year. And finally, Converge ICT more than doubled its fiber network to over 55,000 kilometers last year, putting it on track to reach 15 million households by the year 2025. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.